Hey everyone, my name is Tim, and I'm standing in front of this green screen right now so I can show you how to use the Chroma Key tool in KineMaster. Just like that.
So I'm in KineMaster now, and I want to explain how I set up the shot you just saw. Chroma keying is a compositing technique that is often used to place a subject in a different background scene. For my shot, I have a background scene on my primary media track, and this footage of myself standing in front of the green screen on a video layer. When the two are composited together, it looks like I'm standing in the background scene. It is important to note that this feature requires video layers, which are only available on supported devices that are powerful enough to use this feature. Okay, I will delete these clips and then set up a new Chroma Key shot from scratch. First, I will add my background scene on the primary media track. Since I plan to use a still image for my background, I'm going to go to Project Settings, tap Editing, and choose Fill Screen for my default photo cropping setting. This will prevent the image from panning and zooming on the screen, which would look unnatural for my background. Then I will tap Media, and I'm going to choose my Favorites folder. Then I will tap on my background clip to add it to my primary media track. Now I will jump back to the beginning of the timeline and add the footage of myself on the green background as a video layer. Tap Layer, Media. I will navigate to my Favorites folder again and select my video clip. Scale the layer to fit your scene. At this point, I will mention a couple of things that will help you get good results when you are shooting footage that will be used for chroma keying. First, you often see people using a green screen or a blue screen for this technique, but really any solid, saturated color will work. Avoid neutrals like white, black, or gray. Green and blue work well because they are far away in color from skin tones. Make sure your key color is not the same as or close to a color found on your subject. Another thing that will help is to make sure the background is evenly lit, with no shadows. Since the masked area, or transparent part of the image, is based on a color, you want that color to be consistent throughout the image. Darker or lighter tones could make it difficult for you to achieve a clean mask. Keeping some distance between the colored background and the subject will help you avoid shadows on the background, and will also prevent the background color from reflecting or spilling onto your subject. Alright, it's time to remove the green background. In the Options panel, tap Chroma Key. Tap on the switch to enable the tool. Right away, you can see it has an effect on my footage, but I do need to make some adjustments to the mask. The first step is to make sure you have a good color selected as the key color. KineMaster will select a key color based on your footage, and this is almost always correct right away. However, you can choose a different color by tapping on the colored circle to open the color picker. At the top, you will see a selection of recommended key colors. KineMaster suggests super saturated versions of the colors in your footage to help you get a clean key. I would stick with one of these recommended colors for best results. In most cases, you won't have to change the color at all, so I'm going to leave that alone. The next thing I do is turn on this Show Mask option. This will help you visualize what is being keyed out and what is being kept. Pure black will be totally transparent, and pure white is totally solid, while gray tones are semi-transparent. I will adjust the foreground and background cutoff sliders to try to get the background totally black and the subject totally white. Starting with the foreground slider, I'm going to move it to the left only as far as I need to in order to make my silhouette solid. Then I will bring the background slider to the right as far as I can to make the background totally black without making holes in the subject area. Now, when I turn off the Show Mask option, I should have a clean mask. The last thing you may want to do is adjust the detail curve. This affects the blending between the foreground and background cutoff. You can use this to help refine the edge of your mask. Curves to the top left will bias toward keeping the foreground solid, while curves to the bottom right will fade away more of the foreground edge. Okay, so that is Chroma Key in a nutshell. Keep in mind that this technique is not just for putting people into a different background. You can use Chroma Key for special effects or even compositing motion graphics. Let me show you a quick example of a motion graphic. I'm in a new empty KineMaster project. The first thing I need to do is add a background, so I'll tap Media and then Background. I'll tap on Black and then tap the check mark. Next, I'll extend this layer to about 10 seconds. Then I want to change the color to blue. Now I'll jump back to the beginning of the timeline. And I want to add a handwriting layer, so I'll tap Layer, Handwriting. I'm going to use the Rectangle tool. and I want to choose a red color for this graphic, I'm going to use the color wheel, and I'll just pick a bright red. Okay. I want to draw a large rectangle near the middle of the screen that will be used as a background for some text. I'm going to draw it a little larger than what I need for my final composition. Then I'll tap over to the Options panel. And I want to give this layer a descriptive name, so I'll tap Information, and then add a label. Then I'm going to long press on the layer and drag it down the timeline just a little bit, and drag the out point somewhere near the end of the timeline. Next, I'm going to repeat this process, drawing another rectangle. I'll put the playhead just a little after the start of the first layer, then tap Layer, Handwriting. I'm going to change the color to a slightly darker shade of red, and then draw a rectangle over the top of the first one, making sure to completely cover the edges. Then I'll tap over to the Options panel again. I'll rename the layer. And I'll drag the out point so that the second layer ends slightly before the first layer. And now we need to repeat this process one more time. I'll tap Layer, add a handwriting layer, change the color to be slightly darker yet, and draw another rectangle. Rename the layer. And adjust the out point. Now if I expand the timeline, you can see that we've created this sort of inverted pyramid shape. And that's what we want to see. The next thing I need to do is set the in and out animation for all of these layers. So I'll tap on first, and for the in animation, I'm going to scroll near the bottom and choose enter slide up. And I'll set my duration to 1.5. Then for the out animation, I'll scroll down and choose exit slide down. And again, I'll choose 1.5 for the duration. Now just repeat this process for the second and third layers. Enter slide up. 1.5. Exit slide down. And one more time. Let me scrub through the timeline and show you what that looks like. These overlapping layers are animating nicely now, but we still have to clean up the edge. For that, I'll need another handwriting layer. Tap Layer, Handwriting. This time, change the color back to blue. And what I want to do this time is create rectangles that overlap each edge of the graphic. This will make each side of the rectangle even when it's animating. Let me show you what I mean. I'll start on the left side, then move to the bottom, now I'll do the right side, and the top. Then I'll tap over to the Options panel, and I'll label this layer Blue Frame. Okay. Then I'll drag the in and out point of this layer to the beginning and end of the timeline. Let's see how that looks. Now that the animation is looking pretty good, let's add some text. Tap layer, text. For this example, I'll make a subscribe graphic for a YouTube channel. So I'll type the word subscribe and I'll hit OK. I'm going to scale up the text by dragging from the corner. Then I'll scroll down in the options panel and remove the shadow. And I want to change the font to something a little more interesting. So I like this display type font. Now I want this text to animate onto the screen with the handwriting layers. So let's find a good point where it should come on. I will long press and drag the text layer to about this point in the timeline, and then set the in and out animation. For the in animation, I'll choose enter slide up again. And for the out animation, exit slide down. Now let's decide where the text should end. That's pretty close. I think it could go just a little longer. The last thing I want to do is add a little flicker before the text animates off the screen. For that, I'll need to make a duplicate copy of the text layer. Tap this menu and choose Duplicate. Change the color of the new layer to blue. Next, I want to remove the in and out animation. So I'll scroll back to the top and select None. And finally, I want to trim the start and end of this clip. I will have it end right before the text begins to animate, and have the clip start just about a second earlier. Then I'll change the overall animation to flicker. I will play that all the way through once so you can see it. Then I'll go ahead and export this graphic. Once your video is exported, you'll have a file that can be used again and again as a layer in other projects. To add the graphic to this project, I'll tap Layer, Media, then I'll go to the Export folder, and choose the file I just exported. When I enable the Chroma Key effect, the graphic will be composited into my video. Take a look at the way it animates onto the screen here. Or see how it could be used with more of a stylized background further down the timeline. Be creative and find your own ways to use Chroma Key in your video projects. Thanks for watching.